Hello dear fans, friends and subscribers. Welcome to your daily cricket show and your favorite show, the Cricket Happening Show with your host Ram. Well, as far as today's cricket show is concerned, I have to definitely start off with this news. We know I'm going to talk about the Indian Premier League 2017, which kicked off today, where it resulted in the defending champs Sunrise Hyderabad winning. But I will come back to that later, because the first news that I would like to share on this cricket show of mine is without any doubt to say that the Indian captain Virat Kohli has been honored by the as a leading cricketer in the world in the 2017 edition of the WISDEN Cricketer Almanac. So that is something, it's a very proud thing. And the reason that Virat Kohli was named the leading cricketer in the world was because his average in all the three formats of the game was absolutely phenomenal. He had an average of 75 in test matches, 92 in one day internationals, and 106 in T20s. So that's a phenomenal average in all the three formats of the game. And that was a precise reason Virat Kohli was named the leading WISDEN cricketer. I mean, the leading cricketer in the world in this year, WISDEN 2017, the almanac of 2017, where Virat Kohli will be figuring on the cover photo of the WISDEN Cricketers Almanac. As you know, it's an annual magazine, the WISDEN Cricketer. And also, I have to say that Kohli is the third Indian to win an award, a WISDEN award. The first being Sachin Tendulkar in the year. Sachin Tendulkar did it once. Virendra Sehwag had the honor of actually getting the WISDEN Cricket Award twice in consecutive years, 2008 and 2009. And now the proud privilege goes to Virat Kohli, and undoubtedly he was the leading cricketer of the world. And also, let me tell you, this time the WISDEN Cricketers Almanac also the leading five cricketers of the year are, one is Virat Kohli leading the way, and then we have two Asians, two players from the Asian countries, and one the second and third comes from Pakistan, and I'm very happy to see that as well. Yunis Khan of Pakistan is number two. Misbah ul Haq, the cool as a cucumber captain of Pakistan, is number three. And then we have it's Chris Wokes. Now Chris Wokes, you know what an improved cricketer he is. So Chris Wokes has gone to such an extent that he has been also been named as the fourth cricketer in WISDEN. Is Chris Wokes, and the fifth one or the final one, Toby Rowland-Jones, whose hat-trick, and Ben Duckett were also named. So it was this is how the WISDEN Cricketers Almanac was completed, with the leading cricketers in the world. And as I said, Virat Kohli, the Indian captain, will be very proud of this achievement. And why not? I mean, a person who averages 75 in test matches, 92 in one day internationals, and 106 in 2020 internationals can't be there anywhere other than WISDEN. I mean, it is a phenomenal achievement by Virat Kohli, and I'm sure India will be very proud of this phenomenal achievement done by the Indian captain Virat Kohli. As we all know, he definitely had a dismal series against Australia, but that is I would say that is just nothing to read into, because every great player goes through a bout of bad form, and I'm sure Virat Kohli is going to emerge more fitter and more stronger, especially after getting this encouraging news of being named the leading cricketer. I'm sure Virat Kohli will be firing on all cylinders against all oppositions in the year 2017. Well, so from here I'm going to leave. So this is the first thing that I wanted to talk on my cricket show. And the other things that are coming on the cricket show is, today was the start of the Indian Premier League 2017, which saw the Sunrisers Hyderabad, the defending champions, living up to their billing in the first match of the Indian Premier League 2017 at the Rajiv Gandhi International Stadium, Uppal in Hyderabad, where definitely one has to say Royal Challengers were depleted by the absence of Rahul, Kohli and De Villiers, but one has to really commend the efforts of the Royal Challengers for bringing the match so close. I mean, Sunrisers Hyderabad won the match with only 35 runs, which I'll be talking about. Yuvraj Singh played a real blinder of an innings here, and was good to see from the Sunrisers Hyderabad point of view, and which even made the David Warner, the captain of Sunrisers Hyderabad, say that Yuvraj's strokes that were flowing were probably coming, were reminding him of the old Yuvraj Singh, and that is really good news, I would say. And the other cricket news that I'll be looking at is, as you know, Shadab Khan, who was the man of the series in the recently concluded matches, the T20, which was played between West Indies and Pakistan, has been included in the Test matches. So Shadab Khan has broken into the Test matches now, and we will have a look at the Pakistan Test squad that has been selected for the first Test match, which is going to be starting between Pakistan and West Indies. So so that's the news of the 18-year-old bloke Shadab Khan breaking into the Test matches after his brilliant performance in T20s. Now first I'm going to start off with the IPL. Definitely there'll be more concentration on this, and as I said, today it was the start of the Indian Premier League 2017, which kicked off at the Rajiv Gandhi Upal International Stadium. Royal Challengers were depleted, and probably one would have never given a chance to Royal Challengers, but there's no cricket definitely has this tag of glorious uncertainties, but nothing of that sort happened, and Sunrisers Hyderabad eventually, or probably I would say fittingly, were the winners by 35 runs. The toss was a good toss to win. The toss was won by the new Royal Challengers captain Shane Watson, who decided that they would bowl first at the Sunrisers Hyderabad. So Sunrisers Hyderabad batted. David Warner and Shikhar Dhawan opened the innings. And today the opening partnership could not last long. As you know, David Warner and Dhawan were responsible for some great partnership, and they were primarily responsible for providing a lot of good opening partnership in the IPL 2016, which really paved the way for laying a foundation, and then the other players capitalized. But today it was not to be. Aniket Chowdhury was the one who drew first blood, but not before David Warner had slammed 14 of just 8 deliveries, which included 2 fours and 1 six. So 19 for 1 in the second over. Dhawan was joined in by Moises Enriquez. Dhawan definitely flowed well. He showed some real stroke making there, and Dhawan was really looking in good nick at the time. And Moises Enriquez was also playing some good strokes, and Dhawan and Moises Enriquez slowly helped the Sunrisers Hyderabad recover from a stage where they were 19 for 1 to take the score on to 93, which was very well done by both the batsmen. But after that, it was Stuart Binney who nipped up the wicket of Shikhar Dhawan for 40 of 31 deliveries, 5 fours. But also let me tell you that Tymal Mills, for the first time, was playing for the RCB. I mean, he was representing in the IPL for the first time, and I thought he bowled well as well. Other than that, after Shikhar Dhawan left, it was really big hitting, crisp hitting, and also some graceful hitting coming in from the bat of Yuvraj Singh. As Yuvraj Singh really reminded one of his old demeanor that he had when he used to play the strokes, and that is to just stay over there and literally just time the ball to absolute precision. And the short balls were dispatched with disdain, and also the shots that he plays, how he actually goes and actually lofts it over the cover region, and he also dominated anything on the leg side, were beautifully clipped over the square leg region for sixes. And it was very, very good to see that Yuvraj was in his element today, as Moises Enriquez was partnering him as the score reached 151 in the 16th over. And that was the time Yuvraj Chahal, who was the best bowler today for the RCB, actually picked up his wicket when Moises Enriquez was out for 52. A very good catch taken by Sachin Bedi at the end defense of the bowling of Chahal. 52 of 37 dealt with 3 fours and 2 sixes. And Yuvraj Singh continued in his own way, and he was there till the 19th over. And when he departed, he had he also hit Timal Mills for a beautiful six. And Yuvraj Singh, in fact, Timal Mills was trying to get his leg cutter going, but Yuvraj Singh was absolutely equal to the challenge as he thrust him into the stands. And Yuvraj Singh finally was clean bowled by Timal Mills for 62 of 27 deliveries, 7 fours and 3 spanking sixes, as Sunrisers Hyderabad finally made 207 for 4 with Deepak Hooda not out on 16 of 12 balls with one big six. Cutting hit 2 sixes in an unbeaten knock of 16 of just 6 deliveries, as Sunrisers Hyderabad finished their 20 overs quota, and the score read 207 for 4. As far as the bowling from the RCB was concerned, as I said, Yuzendra Chahal was the pick of the bowlers. 4 overs, 1 for 22, even though Yuvraj Singh was really firing on all cylinders and Moises Enriquez was doing a good job, Yuzendra Chahal was the one who was having real control over the Sunrisers Hyderabad batsman. Timal Mills, on his first on his debut in the IPL, 4 overs no made and 1 for 31. Aniket Chowdhury took the wicket, but he went for plenty. 4 overs was carted for 55. In fact, Yuvraj Singh really belted him all across the park. Yuzendra Chahal 1 for 22. Arvind, 3 overs was very costly. Leaked 36 of his 3. Watson went for 41 of his 3. Travis Head bowled 1 over for 11. And Stuart Binney bowled 1 over, 1 for 10. Now, with the turn of the Royal Challengers Bangalore, it's interesting to see as to how Royal Challengers Bangalore would be doing after the team was depleted with 3 big names missing. And Chris Gayle, definitely, as I said yesterday, had the onus of taking it on for the Royal Challengers Bangalore. So Chris Gayle and Mandeep Singh were the ones who actually opened for Royal Challengers Bangalore. Chris Gayle was already started his pyrotechnics by slamming some sixes. I mean, he started off in a subdued fashion, but later on we saw Chris Gayle get into his groove as those sixes and fours started coming out. But then Gayle and Mandeep Singh were in the middle. And then one saw a very bold move coming in from the skipper of the Sunrisers Hyderabad, David Warner, tossing the ball to the young leggie Rashid Khan. As you know, Afghanistan player Rashid Khan in Afghanistan for making their debut for the first time in the Indian Premier League. And Rashid Khan, the young leggie, was tossed the ball. And it was a bold move, I thought, by David Warner to bring him on. And Rashid Khan stuck in his very first over when Mandeep Singh was fooled by a delivery from Rashid Khan, and Mandeep Singh was clean bowled for 24 of 16 deliveries, but he played a very strokeful knock with 5 boundaries. After that, Travis Head and Gayle were in the middle, but Gayle, after spanking some 3 sixes and 2 fours in a knock of 32 of 21 balls, it was one more bold move from David Warner to bring in Deepak Hooda, the off-spinner. It was David Warner's good captaincy, I thought. He thought that Chris Gayle was the crease, and he said an offie would really do the trick. So Deepak Hooda was actually dismissed for a 6 of the first ball. But the very next delivery, there was a wicket for Deepak Hooda as he claimed Gayle's wicket, getting him caught by Warner. And Warner was absolutely ecstatic because he knew that Chris Gayle was the danger man for them. And also his moves worked, so I thought it was good captaincy on the part of David Warner from the Sunrisers Hyderabad. Travis Head and Kedar Jadhav in the middle, so they definitely needed to take a bit of their time, which they definitely did. But at the same time, they saw to it that they were really keeping the runs sticking in, as Travis Head and Jadhav played very well to put up a good partnership, as the score went by 56 runs. There was a 56-run partnership which took the score on to 116, and then it was Kedar Jadhav who was run out brilliantly by cutting for 31 of 16, that is 4 fours and 1 6. And then Rashid Khan once again in the picture, getting a wrong one to Travis Head, and Travis Head was gone. Caught Yuvraj Singh. Rashid Khan, the leggy, impressing on his debut with 2 wickets for 31 on his 2 wickets for 36, which still was a good effort from leggie in a T20 match. So Rashid Khan taking his wicket, head was gone for 30 of 22 balls, 3 fours. After that, it was always going to be difficult. Shane Watson was there, the hope was still there, but Shane Watson was the only one who contributed with 22 of 17, 1-4 and 1-6, falling a victim of Nehra. And Nehra also became the first bowler in Indian Premier League to pass the 100 wicket mark. I mean, that was wicket number 100 for Ashish Nehra in Indian Premier League. He has been very successful, as you know, in Indian Premier Leagues. Sachin Bedi was out cheaply, and then the pressure started building on the Royal Challengers batsman as wickets started falling. Bedi was out to Bipul Sharma for one. Binny was out to the bowling Bhuvneshwar Kumar of 11 of 10 balls with 1-6. Arvind lost his stumps to Ashish Nehra for naught. Tymal Mills was a victim of Kumar for 6. Chahal left for 3. And there was absolutely no resistance from the lower middle order. And the Royal Challengers Bangalore finally had to surrender at 172 all out. And thus, the Sunrisers Hyderabad winning the inaugural match of the Indian Premier League, sorry, the curtain raiser of the Indian Premier League 2017 with a very good win. In fact, they won the match by 35 runs. But definitely, I would really credit the Royal Challengers Bangalore for stretching the Sunrisers Hyderabad here, even being so very crippled as far as their team composition was concerned. Now, looking at the bowling as far as the Sunrisers Hyderabad was concerned, Ashish Nehra, 4 overs, 2 for 42. Bhuvneshwar Kumar was on the money, 4 overs, 2 for 27, cutting 3.4 overs, none for 35. But Rashid Khan, as I said, on his very first match, Afghanistan, making their debut in the Indian Premier League 2017, Rashid Khan definitely deserves kudos on his first match. 4 overs for 36 runs, but he picked up 2 wickets, and that was very important wickets too. Deepak Hooda, 1 for 7, bricked up the most dangerous player, Chris Gayle's wicket. Andre Gaze, none for 20 of 2. Bipul Sharma, 1 for 4. I have to say that credit to David Warner, the Sunrisers Hyderabad captain, for leading the team well, and he made some bold moves which really paid off, and it was good captaincy, I thought, from him. And the player of the match going to Yuvraj Singh for one special innings that he played, which really paved the way for the Sunrisers Hyderabad to actually go and sit on a total of 207, which was the second highest total in the IPL. And that was it. So it's the first match, as expected, Sunrisers Hyderabad winning the match. But definitely, I would say, I would commend the Royal Challengers Bangalore for really stretching it and allowing the Sunrisers Hyderabad to win only by 35 runs. Now, the tomorrow's match, which is coming up, I'm told it's going to be between Rising Pune Super Giants and the Kings XI Punjab. Rising Pune Super Giants is led by a new captain, Stephen Smith. And also the Kings XI Punjab are led by a new captain, Glenn Maxwell. So that is the match which is coming up tomorrow. As far as the, before I go here, I would like to talk to you about a cricket news, in the sense, as I was talking about Shadab Khan. Now, Shadab Khan, we know how he performed in the T20. He picked up the man of the series in the T20 international debut against the West Indies. And now, as you know, in the first test match is starting on April 21st at Kingston in Jamaica. And the Pakistan squad, I have to say, this is a big inclusion. After looking at Shadab Khan, the 18-year-old bloke who has been, who really, really troubled the West Indies batsmen, I thought it was a very good move. They have roped in Shadab Khan. Shadab Khan has been selected or included in the test squad, and I thought that's great encouragement for Shadab Khan, the 18-year-old boy. And Pakistan squad, just to talk about the Pakistan squad, Ahmed Shahzad makes his way back into the test matches here, which is very interesting to see. Shadab Khan is another. Shan Masood makes a comeback into the Pakistan team. But there are some new faces as well. Hassan Ali gets an opportunity in test matches for the first time. But there are two new faces by the name Usman Salahuddin and Mohammad Abbas. Just to talk about Usman Salahuddin, I would like to give you some information. I'm told that both Usman Salahuddin basically bats in the middle order, and also Abbas is a pace bowler, Mohammad Abbas. So these are the reasons, and they have been selected as well. As far as the omissions are concerned, for the first test match between Pakistan and West Indies. Shadab Khan, as he was in hot water in the Pakistan Super League. Sohail Khan is gone. There's no Sohail Khan. Sami Aslam loses his place. But now that has come as a real surprise for me. I have to say this, dear friends, subscribers, because one has always thought that Sami Aslam, after making his debut against England, one thought that Sami Aslam was absolutely test material. And that has really come as a surprise, because I always have felt that Sami Aslam is absolutely test match material, and one wonders as to why Sami Aslam has been left out of the squad. Rahat Ali loses his place, Mohammad Rizwan is out, and Mohammad Nawaz and Imran Khan are all out. So, but I am really concerned about Sami Aslam, because I definitely feel that Sami Aslam has a good technique, and as far as test matches are concerned, I would definitely vouch for Sami Aslam. So I'm a bit surprised here. As I said, I am nobody to talk about it, but I'm just giving my opinion. So I'm really surprised that Sami Aslam has been left out of the test squad. Well, dear fans, subscribers, I have nothing else to add as far as today's. Yes, one more thing before I go. Tomorrow is going to be the swan song match in T20s for the Bangladeshi captain, Mashrafe Murtaza, when Bangladesh take on Sri Lanka in the final T20, which will decide, you know, Sri Lanka have already won the first T20, and the second T20, Bangladesh have to really make a good pitch. They can give a good send-off to their captain, Mashrafe Murtaza, by winning the second T20. Well, whether that happens, that will be known tomorrow. And with all the IPL updates and all the IPL scores, I'll be back once again tomorrow. Till such time, it's good night from my studios.